I was shocked. It was like somebody hit me with an uppercut.
They are a nonprofit organization that helps kids before and after school, and now they become a victim of catalytic converter thefts right before this school year begins. It could not come at a worse time, since school starts here in less than a month, and they help support kids in South Nashville. It is why the founder of the organization called Caresse Jackman and is turning to the community for help.
I put him in storage.
Marcus Manise thought he was keeping his shuttle buses secure at the storage facility off Antioch Pike.
They cut these right here.
Turns out thieves had other plans.
They opened the gate here and they vandalized four of our vans for after school.
Four vans Manise uses to help children in Antioch through his program Stronger Than My Father.
I put them in storage hoping that nobody would touch them over the summer since we wouldn't have summer school. And wow, they even got me, they even breaking it over here at the storage unit.
And right underneath these shuttle buses, you can see what they stole. Catalytic converters. His vans pick up about 125 students for his organization's before and after school program. With school starting in August, he's hoping they can get their buses fixed in time.
These services are needed to help kids in the community and parents who need a safe place for their kids for after school. So without the vans, we can't even take kids to school, nor can we even pick them up after school.
News 4 highlighted the rise in catalytic converter thefts across the nation.
They're gonna cut it, they're gonna snip it, they're gonna drag it out.
And Nashville isn't immune. MNPD tells News 4 they've seen an uptick, nearly 270 reports across Davidson County so far this year. A new state law is working to reduce the number of catalytic converter thefts across the state. It requires people buying unattached catalytic converters to be registered as a scrap metal dealer. It also requires the person selling a detached catalytic converter to provide documentation and ID. As the countdown to the school year gets closer, Manise is not going to let this setback hold him back from helping the children and community he adores so much.
I still smile because, like I said, we're still doing God's work and we're hoping that the community can support us in any kind of way.
I'm Call for Action Problem Solver, Caresse Jackman, News 4 Nashville.
Wow. Well, if you would like to help out Manise and his organization, we have posted a link to their website on our website, WSMV.com.